Hi guys, welcome back to Test Automation Design from Scratch. So in this session, let's continue with branching and merging in distributed version control system. So before that, as a prior thing, we want to just have a quick recap of what we have done in the earlier video, that is get every day commands. So before that, I wanted to give a brief bit of clarification on some of the areas. So here we have seen the basic git every day commands like git init, git init, git add. So initiating a repository, adding the changes to the stage, adding the changes to the staging area, and then committing the changes, and then how to revert back the changes, and how to verify the status of the changes, and how to verify the log, how to verify using the log, the history of the commits that have been made. We also see how to open the graphical tool and verify the revision of all the changes, all the commits in a graphical manner, in a tree structure. So let's navigate back to team and repository view. In repository view, basically I have seen, we have been discussing about some, while initializing a Git repository, we have a difference that has been seen. So when initiating under the same working directory, under the same directory structure, the problem is that you can see the working tree and also the Git repository, local Git repository exists in the same area, the same directory. So that's the problem while we are creating in the same working directory. So that is why it was not at all a recommended way to do it. And while in the other way, when we are doing it, you could see in the Git working tree, we have Git repository in a separate folder structure or a directory, and our Git project structure is existing in a separate directory. So this is the way we need to do it. This is the recommended approach. And in this first approach, you could see our project and also our Git repository are in the same working tree, under the same working tree, under the same directory structure. So whatever changes we have made, it will always be in the same directory, and there will be some problems with it. So that's the reason we are not going with this approach. This is the clarification that we wanted to give it. And once this is done, and we are looking at, and next we need to look at how to revert back to the commits, and also we need to how to verify the git diff in a diff viewer, in the graphical view, I mean in the Eclipse version. We have seen how to see the diff in command line tool. Let's see in Eclipse, how to view it in Eclipse. So let's open graphical view. So in here, create a file and make some changes. All right, assume we are going to make some changes to this particular file. So just printing out the statement. So these are the lines of code that we are including. So now this file, we have made some changes to this file. So this file will be having some untracked changes. So which we need to index this file using the git add command. So let's see, let's navigate, let's open the synchronized view. Let's see, we can see over here the files that have been having some changes. So this is the file that we have made some changes to. So we wanted it to add. So we need to add it to the staging area. So you can see from unstaged to staging changes has been moved. Now we need to click on commit, click on receive. Make this commit. Then click on confirm. Now the changes have been synced to our local Git repository. So you can see there are no changes in the Git. You can also see over here, there are no outgoing, there are no incoming changes. So let's close this. And let's navigate to Java perspective. And let's open the history. So let's see it in history, the commits that have been made. So we are in the master branch, and this is the latest commit that we have made. So click on it. So right click on it and open in commit viewer. Once you're done, you can see this is the commit message we have given, and this is the commit ID, and this is the file that have been committed, and what is the branch? The branch is the master. In this branch, we have made a commit, and you can see over here the two tabs, commit and diff. This is the committed and thread information, and click on diff, we'll get all the diff related information. So you can see that we have added these lines of codes. So next, come back to the same place in the project and remove this line. So basically we should not remove it, we should comment it. No changes made, so just what we need to do it, copy it and place it again and comment it and then remove it. Then save the changes. Now there are some changes that need to be changed. So again, you can add it to the staging area. So use add to index. Once this was done, so to view this, we need to go into Git staging view. The Git staging view, you'll be able to see there are no changes in unstaged changes. And now we have made the unstaged changes to staged changes. This is the file that has been staged. And then latest edit and click on commit. So now it has been synced. So to verify, nothing has been there. I mean, everything was synced. There were nothing was there to be synced. You can see it. You can use the command git status, and you see it should navigate to this particular directory folder and then copy this working tree. Okay, now use git status. Okay, so we are not in that particular directory. Our local repository was here. our local repository was in new repository path, not in git test path. So I forgot to use the cd command. So now we are in the new repository path, and now let's use git status. You see, we are on the branch master and there is nothing to commit. So everything was in sync, that is the local working directory is in sync with the git repository. So now let's see the history of the changes that have been made. Navigate to team, show in history, or you have a history view over here. Click on this. You can see this is the file that has been changed, and you can directly see over here the latest edit with the command that has been made. And if you click on this, you can see what are the differences that have been made. So earlier this is the file, now this is the change that has been made. So this line of code that has been there, we have commented that. So that is the changes. So if you wanted to view in diff viewer, open commit viewer and click on diff. So you can see this line of code has been removed. So it's highlighted in red color, and this is the line of code that has been created, added. So this is shown in green color. So this is how we use the git diff viewer to verify the difference. So commit viewer, we will navigate to the commit viewer, and then we'll be verifying the diff in the diff tab, from the diff tab. So if you wanted to revert back the diff, revert back the commit that we have made, so how to do it? So right click on this latest commit that we have made and use revert commit. So once you do this, one more commit will be there that has been there with mention of the statement with revert, and what we are reverting is the latest the commit message that we have provided. It shows revert and the latest latest commit message with the latest commit message. So revert latest edit. So this has been reverted back. So how to verify whether it has been reverted back or not is using this view. Now let's close everything. So you can see the reverter changes. So the changes have been reverted. You can clearly see over here in our file. And you can also see by typing the git status, git status, so that it should show there was nothing to commit in the working area. So it shows there is nothing to commit and working tree is clean. So this is the basic the today commands, everyday commands, git everyday commands that we have covered up. And now let's see how to work with branching and merging. So for that, let's create a new project once again. How to do it? Now, so click on File, New, Others, and now in project, click next. Create a simple project using the cube type artifact, and then give the name for the group identity, artifact ID for uniquely identifying this project. I'm giving project 1 as a name and I'm saving it. The project has been created with the cube type artifact based on the template that is available for the cube type artifact. The directory structure has been created like this. So we are not having any anything. It's everything fresh. So from the beginning, let's now create local Git repository to track this project. So we should not use our create repository in the parent folder. So that is not the recommended way. So if you select this, it shows like creation of repositories in the Eclipse workspace. It is not a recommended approach. So click on create and select where you want to create. Practical. Give a new name. Launching and merging. So we want to track this project under this directory structure. So select this folder. Finish. So under E practical, Git practical branching and merging, Git local repository will be created now. Click on finish. Can see over here there are some files that are not tracked with the local repository, since the Git repository is a fresh one, it's an empty one. So these files, this repository information needs to be tracked. So for that we need to add these files to the index using the staging area, to the staging area using index, and then after that we need to commit the changes. So that those all this project related information will be tracked under our local Git repository. Now go to properties. You see under Git, this is the directory path. So you can see we are having under this project structure this working directory. Working tree, we will be having our local repository and our project. So in this one, you see there are no branches. So the default branch will be master. There are no hooks. There are references, heads, and in heads there is nothing. So since it was empty, there was nothing inside it. There was nothing. So we have created an empty Git repository. Now the repository is created, and let's open up the synchronization view. So you can see these are all the files that we wanted that needs to be that are unstaged, and we need to add them using the index, the staging area, and then we need to commit so that our local repository and our working directory will be in sync. Select all, and over here you can see 6 files need to be staged. That's what the information it gives. Click on add to index. Once you do that, you can see the sign appears on all these folders, all these files. So there are 6 files. So let's open Git perspective and now get to Git staging. It was pointing to new repository, but our repository is a different one. So we need to open using switch repository, branching and merging, so that we can see these are the stage changes. So now we need to make commit for this. You can see. Git every day. Everyday commit, everyday commands, basic everyday commands, committed, click on commit. So all the changes are in states now. You can see over here, branching and merging is our repository. You can even close these things. Remove the repository from the view. So that should be clear for us. It works now. So I'm closing the repository. So you can see over here. You can see other branches, local branches. Master is the basic branch that will be available. So we have committed all the changes from the working directory to the staging it, sorry, the local repository. So everything was in synchronous. To see this one, it was over here, so we can use. It's settled, so it says that the working directory is clear and there was no changes made, so there are no unstaged changes. So now let's see the working tree. You can see another working tree, local repository is there. Other than that, you can see project, the project one, which is being tracked. So you can see some new files have been added, that is committed with message, that is the latest commit message will be added.